lonely. I know there's something in the wake of your smile. I get a notion from the look in your eyes. You've built a love, but our love falls apart. You little piece of heaven, you little piece of heaven. I know there's something in the wake of your smile. I get a notion from the look in your eyes. You've built a love, but our love falls apart. You little piece of heaven. There's too dark. Listen to your heart. Listen to your heart.
There we go. We're muted. There we go. It's been a few days. I've been a bit sick, but trying to get back into it. Lots of fever, lots of throat issues. So yeah, it's been a few days. Competition finished yesterday, unfortunately. I didn't finish top 100 this time, actually by some stupid mistakes I did. As you probably know, if you participated, the town was, the cash was very small for the the meta sales. So what happened was that I forgot to redo or remove the money stuff so I could get extra production in the like the last day, because I was doing in my test, I was doing like over 100, over 200, and I completely forgot. I had some personal issues and I had my health not helping. So I ended up just letting it ride, and I ended up like just shy of top 100, which is a shame. I had a good layout. I had a good chance to land a top 100, but unfortunately other things got in the way. Legacy was released yesterday also. We jumped in just to check it out. We've built a few things. I've been playing around a bit with it, trying to discover how kind of like how this works, and I'm not sure exactly how the monetization is on this game, but I think it has to do with these green gems here. You can farm these, collect these to 100 when the timer runs out, and then you can apply for the competitions that the game offers, and that's if you rank. Then I think that's where your rewards come from. So that should be it, but I don't know exactly. I'm just starting the game. It's just playing around, see how it looks, see how it feels. But yeah, it's kind of okay. I mean, it's not really, how can I say? It's not a very active game that you can participate in it like all day, and you can play all day. Well, you can, I guess, if you want to speed things up and you want to faster production, you can click on the items to for them to just get dispatched faster. But overall, I think the game runs well, like idly. You come back to it, you make upgrades, you build stuff, and you just, you know, see how it goes. As you can see here, is like 10 seconds left for the next competition. You have not unlocked design competitions yet. This will come from your advisor. So yeah, we got the research lab. We've been researching slowly a few things. We got this research here still going, the roof burger. Once that's done, we install it, and then we'll get some bonuses from it. I guess it has to do with production and stuff. It's the tutorial was good. It led me to kind of like the basic stuff, how things work. But there's some things I really don't, I'm not following yet. I guess with time we'll understand how these things work. Because I cannot expand, even if I have money. I don't know how to expand. I don't know if I can do another building or not. So it's kind of strange that the way the game works is just it's just different. I don't know. So you see here, if I click it, I can speed up some of these things. So if I can kick, I can either click, or I can keep holding the mouse button and it just goes. So it depends on what you want to do, I guess. If you want to speed things up, if you're in a competition, sure. But then the game will run idly if you don't want to spend too much time on it. So yeah, that's the way it goes. The purpose of the game is to produce items that have their value balanced as long as with as compared to their cost of production. Then you sell them. Like right now I can only sell 2x2 because of my little building here is not very upgraded. But yeah, that's basically how it goes. You can where is it, design product. You can come here to design product and you can choose your products. You can choose your products that you want to build and produce and sell. Initially you only have some options here, you don't have all the options. But yeah, that's how it goes. You have the premium here, which I don't have anything on. It must be from NFTs or something. But yeah, this is the design I've been rocking for a bit since last night. It's what it is. I'm just trying to understand what this does and how it works, you know. So the cost, this is the cost in terms of resources. And then their value. So you get like a good combination here of like of the cost that it takes to produce and the value that it has. So you can optimize this a little bit. So you can have a good output in terms of like the product you're selling that has low cost of production but higher value for sale, so you can get more cash. that's basically it, I think. It's interesting. Again, I don't know exactly how the monetization works on this one. I know it's still pay to earn, but I don't know exactly how that works. I want to listen to the AMA. I haven't listened to it last night, so I'm just gonna do that and enjoy the talk and the chat and the drama as usual. Probably make some comments on top of it, but yeah, that's where we are right now. I'm gonna stop the music here for a little bit and just dive into the AMA. Let's see.
Hey everybody. Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's see who we got today. We got some Jimmy James back. Hasn't yeah. played okay. in about a year. Nacho G, Gangbusta, Dubstep Rock, of course.
Got my coffee.
How's it going, guys? Wild Moopsie, nice.
Actually, it's done, but, you know.
And while you're here, make sure that you, if you're on the YouTube, or if you're not, I go say it like that. make sure you get a like and subscribe. Turn on the bell so you get notifications.
It's a bit of echo there.
And yeah, today's gonna be short and sweet. We got a guest speaker, the Wild Moopsie.
Not really sure why he's doing this.
A little bit after SageMaker.
Buy gems, cancel gems. So you can buy the gems on the market as well, on the store, so you can participate in these.
Make sure we share
if you're a free to play gamer, then you probably don't want to spend money on these.
Every week you have the option,
unless you kind of like have something going for you that you know you're gonna score well.
You don't have to wait till Friday.
And then guess what? You can make your money back. But I don't know exactly how's that working. That's a spooky little pumpkin there.
People like it when I say GIF with the soft G. So those are nice GIFs.
Well, so it's asking me to change my design now because you can only sell it for so long, I guess.
Has some rewards updates, and then
so what I'm gonna do is just
from Ninja Surprise for
I'll just do a side of things a reset here
for the game stuff.
So let's see.
I've been having all these sorts of questions about guilds. You know, the guidance we want, the vision is that for the game to be much more social than it is now. And
let's see what we can do.
We've been going through the GDD, which Wild Moops contributed to, and
one of these
large parts of. This is the same game as a document we've been
gotta get cheese
well over a year. And now we're doing the guilds part. What?
My cough's coming back. I might have to mute at some point.
It's gonna be actually really fun. I think the features that we're putting in, and the iterations and all that are gonna be awesome.
Now this would be something I would eat.
Wireframes and these use cases. Our devs have put in the estimates on the tasks.
I don't think I want to go with this. And, I'll do another
we'll
burger.
Let you know as that rolls out, hopefully we'll have some in-game screen
value. From 11 cents.
After that,
costs me
we're
two.
We're finding out for the upgradable NFTs.
Yeah, the burger's cheaper to produce and has like
they're on the Gala chain,
a little bit less value, but it's,
and
okay.
You know, as you can imagine, there's a fair amount of complexity there. This will be the game's first ever
another slice of cheese here.
Super excited about that.
And I want to try this.
Just a quick peek behind the curtain.
Yeah, there we
Some
go.
Some of that upgradability depends on the tech we're
That's
putting
different,
in
yeah.
as well.
There we go. A different
so
burger.
We're putting those upgrades after.
$51.
The guild. So
materials used. Battery storage.
Of what's going
That's
on.
Right.
Those are our headlines. Work in progress.
New design.
What is up for rewards, Michelle?
This week we didn't see. We haven't gotten out last week's.
Let's see what we got here
rewards.
From.
Yeah, there's a couple things we're looking at.
What these guys are saying.
Before they get sent out, we're also still kind of onboarding some new team members and making sure those processes are flushed out so that they're easy for everyone to do, you know, quickly and efficiently on a weekly basis. The rewards from last week were still just the standard gala rewards. The rewards for this next coming competition, don't forget our double gala rewards because we did delay that one competition. At the beginning of October, I believe. So this next one, all the gala rewards are going to be double.
Oh yeah, still next week.
No blueprint this week.
Double
next
rewards.
Week, the reward that we'll be sending out will be for the first event in November. So after this double gala reward week, there'll be one with gala and blueprints. So the next 2 weeks are going to be big weeks.
We should
also have the Coco storages out soon. We were waiting on a little bit of data from the node team, but we got it all sorted. So those are just waiting for distribution now. They should be in game after this game update today.
They're very cute. I love the art.
Yeah. I like the next ones too. I don't think we've even said what they are, but I like them a lot.
Yeah, it's so with our new artists, it's so exciting to see how they iterate on it and see the designs as they come to life. That's really fun.
Yeah, I like it. I'm
actually
art.
Put this YouTube window here.
Well, how's it going on the social media, Mr. Ninja?
It's going pretty good.
That's great.
It's going great. Yeah. Sorry, I dropped like one of my tabs there. It's going good. It's awesome. Yeah. yeah, I'll give you guys a little bit of an update here, a little bit more than just a thumbs up. So we're working on a brand new promo video, as you guys know. It's moving along pretty nicely. We got some really good gameplay footage for it. Going to be moving on to a couple more production things, and then we should have that ready for you guys to check out soon. The Zeely rewards have been picked out. We're going to be revealing them. I'm probably going to wait until maybe around November 1st or so to just give you guys a little bit more extra time if you guys want to complete some requests. Just a reminder, it's going to be for the top 35 players this time instead of the top 25. Since it's going to be extended a bit, since there were no rewards last month, so to make up for that, I'm extending the winners list a bit. On top of that, since we're speaking about Zeely, we have a Zeely Halloween quest to get in the spooky spirits here. So I'll be posting the link for that in a little bit. If you guys want to just take a screenshot of your town, if you guys have some nice little decorations or Halloween decorations to make your town look very spooky or, you know, very Halloweeny, then go ahead and share that and claim the Zeely rewards. And then other than that, there was a giveaway. So we're working on getting the details for that finalized, and it should be going out today, actually, around 2 p.m. EST. So be on the lookout for that. We're going to be giving away five, I believe, Wheel of Nightmares and five, the Spooky Ghost Tracks. That's what we're going to be giving away. So there's going to be 10 winners total. So if you guys want to enter the giveaway, be sure to keep an eye out for that link. And the last thing here is I wanted to give a little shout out to Dubstep Rod. He created a nice little jack-o'-lantern build showcase here. So I just kind of wanted to highlight his hard work. He's done really, you know, a lot of great things with content creation for the team. So I just want to, share his work. He's been doing really awesome. And that's it for social media so far.
Exciting.
Yes, exciting.
Yeah, shout out to Mr. Dubstep Rod. Shout out to him.
I think everybody is excited to hear from our guest star, who
guest
reports
star.
That his demise has been greatly exaggerated. Mr. Sagemaker.
Oh yeah.
How's it going?
I'll mute myself first. It's going well.
He's back.
I've kind of transitioned to a new role. Some of you guys have known that. The big question is, what is that? Basically, I'm helping the organization launch games, working with a platform team, support, doing a lot of support work, and just trying to get things a little moving faster, easier, simpler, so that we can get games out the door. Mm-hmm. One of the things, you know, if you've looked, we've launched Champions Arena. We just launched Legacy yesterday. I didn't help much on Poker Go, but supported with a platform team, making sure that they had what they need from that group. So yeah, it's kind of doing a lot of everything and anything. And still meeting with Musashi every single week. Mm-hmm. This game and this team is very near and dear to my heart, as you guys know.
Well, we definitely appreciate
it. I don't know. Seems like he's distancing himself from Townstar, which is a bit of a shame.
As we try to schedule up meetings and
that's what I feel like.
The calendar is full. Right?
It is. Always. Yeah,
really appreciate you taking the time to come in.
Hey, sure, guys. What anybody have any questions? I mean, I can take like 3 minutes to for somebody to ask me a question. Hopefully,
seems like
actually. So last week we read Bitbender read the light paper to us. I think the reception of that was really well received. Thanking him. It was. You know, we didn't have charts and drafts and exact numbers, but we said we weren't going to have that. Mm-hmm. I wondered if there's anything interesting model-wise does Common Ground World match roughly the other games' approaches, or are other games trying something wild and new? Or
that's a great question. What I can share is that we're looking at every single game. And by the way, so as I said, I'm helping out, looking across multiple games right now. We're really trying to tailor the tokenomics model to the game. And I tell you what I mean by that. As we're looking at things, we know that you just can't take a game and bolt a tokenomics model on the side. I mean, you can, but okay, why, right? And instead,
a little bit annoying that you have to have the mouse on top of the window of Legacy, otherwise it just stops.
How do we put the tokenomics?
Doesn't make a lot of sense
into that system, so it's just not this extra. You know, I don't know what you want to call it, extra thing dangling off the side that we have to try to figure out how to make it work.
I can't do anything.
And
it just keeps
each one will have different models.
Keeps freezing everything.
We're testing. We're finding out different ways, and then also involving the game teams in the discussion because they have their own ideas and their own expertise on that.
That makes total sense. I mean, you know, with a 72-hour competition, you know, like we have, that's very different from like a Last Expedition excursion, you know, that might last 20 minutes, right? So
yeah,
it's a bit annoying.
And Legacy has a different model, right? EPX is going to be coming out a little later this year. They have a different model, Common Ground World, and I think, you know, that would, if I have to say anything, we're always evolving, right? I've been deep into conversations with Bitbender, in this case Musashi, and then the other teams, and it's, you know, it's always that intelligent thought what we're trying to put behind it, not just, you know, stamp out a, you know, cookie cutter solution.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like stuff is all over the place. There's not really any
quickly we turned out
incision.
Fishing for a compliment here. How quickly we turned out the new Common Ground mode and the new content. You know, we got the Academy, all that fun stuff.
Wait, what mode? What are you talking about? Common what? Yeah, no, I think, and I've shared this with you guys, and I'm happy to share the community. You guys turned that very, very quickly. I think you surprised the whole company. And that's a testament to the team and all the hard work you guys have done in the last year in terms of reshaping the code base, reshaping the, you know, the live ops flow, and just how tight you are and how well you work together.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
I know the team really, really killed it, and we're just really proud of how it works. It wasn't trivial, right? So to get that in there, and now it's so fun.
It wasn't easy what you guys did. You guys had a really hard job and just nailed it. Sort of like nailing the landing on an Olympic event. You know, you see the gymnast go and hit the pommel horse or whatever, fly over there and just stick it. That's awesome.
Yes. Well, thank you so much.
I see Vulture has a question. NFTs to Gala Chain batch conversion. Aren't you guys already doing that? I heard you guys had already...
conversion?
It's working. It's been tested. I think that the button is just missing from the platform site still. That's the only thing I think that's still in progress, but it's ready. It's working. I think they just have to do that. I know they're making some changes to the website, so it may have got deprioritized behind other website changes.
Okay.
We're just waiting for the button to show up.
Happen to know the person that that works on that group, so I'll just ask him real quick.
Nice.
Okay.
That's awesome. LB Postman, I think the Persistent Town should have that new name change. Does not compute. Sorry, Postman, maybe you can reword that one. So, if that's it for now, I guess while we're waiting on to hear about that, we can scoot on to some, maybe our story time. We think, Michelle, you ready to go into that?
Yeah, let's do that.
All right.
One second before you jump to that, guys, I'm going to step out. It was good to see everybody again, but I will Slack you with a note as soon as I get the answer so you guys can share it with everybody.
Oh, that was a short,
thank you so much.
Short visit. Thank you. Yeah.
Thanks. All right,
guys.
Bye.
Thanks, everybody. Talk to you later.
All right.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
Bye.
That was nice. He was super busy. That was great to have him in here.
He is right. His meeting schedule is absolutely insane. The last couple times I tried to schedule a meeting, it was just so hard to find a little space in there somewhere.
Oh, yeah. It's like opening a bag of Skittles.
I wonder how much caffeine he needs daily. Like hooked up like an IV, like the whole bag of the coffee, and just like, I need caffeine.
That's right. Well, every week we do different, you know, kind of fun topics. Try to keep them brief. You know, we like to focus on the game itself. This week it's costumes. It's spooky season. Is anybody on our team dressing up? How about you, Mr. Ninja?
Oh my god.
I am actually doing like a little family like photo thing with my newborn. I'm jumping on the One Piece bad wagon since, you know, the live action show. So I'm going to be awesome. Luffy, and my kid's going to be Chopper.
Oh my gosh. That's amazing.
Yes, I just had to do it. My wife is like kind of backing out. I was like, you can be Nami. And she's like, I don't want to do it. And I was like, come on. And she's like,
no. Yeah, definitely feel that first year baby. How about you, Farmer Michelle? Are you dressed something, anything fun?
Eeyore. I like to dress up as Eeyore. Oh. I feel like it's very much the opposite of my personality, so it's fun to pretend to be Eeyore for a while.
Oh, man. Love Eeyore. I will be dressing up as a shiny space cowboy. I got my cowboy boots and NASA outfit and everything. That'll be fun.
Oh, awesome.
Sounds like an Elton John like song too.
Oh my god,
space cowboy.
That's right.
Carry on guitar, you know.
And... Elton John, space cowboy. Really.
And last but not least, Mr. Moopsy, do you want to share any? Do you have any?
Yeah, outfits? I have a costume that I have every year. It's basically a Pikachu costume.
We're a big. I think we had the same message before.
Nice. Is it like
so this one just Pikachu postpones it? So this is either
nice. That's
a good or a bad, right?
That was fun. All right. Well, yeah, let's.
I don't know. This seems like a scam.
We can do. Do you want to go first with the cocoa storage there, Farmer Michelle?
Yeah, sure. Ghosts
and shit.
In the game, whenever this next game update comes out
whatever, man.
This afternoon after
sure.
The event ends. And then I had the distribution.
I'll play around with it a little bit.
This afternoon also after the game update. Hopefully the timing will work out well. That's
nice,
that.
Okay.
Yeah, they're the same size as usual.
These guys are sleeping.
Right. Yeah, as far as updates from the engineering, usually what I do is I look at like all the merges that have come in, because I don't want to tell you guys about stuff that hasn't happened, right? Because it could be kicked back to devs from QA or whatever. But yeah, the past week has actually been focused on four
what's
things.
Happened there?
Internal
sales?
Fixes. Bugs that we find, of course.
Something happened.
There was some comment about in the chat, of course, this week about a player who was on the leaderboards and maybe didn't get there honestly. So we improved a couple things there. Fixes on that. We actually got a chance to address some of our outstanding tech debt. Anybody who's worked in
so cheating again
dev environment knows that devs always want to work on that, but we have to fight for it. And we have a really good management team here, so we're able to focus on that.
Is there cheating
and
again?
Working with our game designers. Including fabulous Moopsy and artists on our new content. Now that we're all here and we have our new hires and everything, it's awesome to be able to work on that.
So we got cheating again.
And then planning those guild features. Believe it or not, that it takes a lot of time to plan out these, you know, multi-month efforts. So that's been engineering. That's kind of been the game updates. Not probably necessarily all of that is immediately customer player facing today, but. It's important to know, you know, what's going on behind the scenes a little. There were fixes, of course. We have things that are visible to you all. Leaderboard profile pictures, that was fixed for most people, right? In some cases, the CDN caches the image, and we can't do much about that except ask the CDN to expire it sooner. There may be some edge cases, so be sure to let us know if the leaderboard profile pics are not loading, or they're loading too slowly, or they're just wrong. But that should be fixed. Player's inventory not shown in some cases. That was related to a deployment thing that's been fixed. I believe that was last Friday. A couple of our devs stayed up really late. They went full aggro on that feature. They didn't have to, but they just really wanted to. So they stayed up super late looking into that thing. We did some analytics improvements. You guys are probably like, why is Volcron talking about analytics? Are you guys publishing that? Why do we care? Well, this is useful for confirming account activity. So if you're on Discord or you play the game regularly, and you're like, hey, this guy is moving up in the leaderboard or whatever, can you look into him? One of the things we look at is how authentic has your play been? So we look at all the history of your town, your other towns, What have you done recently? What kind of trades are you making? You know, we capture all that stuff. So looking into that, if, you know, if there's a jump all of a sudden or something weird happens, we can see it. So some more improvements to that and to our build system. Y'all probably don't care about that. And then admin tools. So same thing as you were talking about this week, you're like, hey, what about this dude, you know, on this leaderboard? We have the ability to look into that. And there were a couple things that just needed tweaked on that so we could see some of the logs a little different. I don't want to tell you guys how we do it, but there were looks into that as well. So we do take everything you say super seriously. You know, we get all the bug reports looking into it. So that is kind of our fixes for this week. And anybody's got any questions, just throw them there in the Discord.
That kind of scares me a little bit.
Yeah, not a lot cheating going on in the Discord today.
Yeah, cheating again.
Quiet. All right. What about cornstarch ingredients? LV Postman. Is there anything we should say about that?
Yeah, I set up all the bot commands yesterday.
Okay.
There you go. Four corn and a wood. Made in a windmill, stored in the storehouse.
That is so cool. Well, how about the upcoming content? What would you say about that?
The new stuff coming into the game this week?
Mm-hmm. Let's hear it.
I'm pretty excited to see the trick-or-treat bags. I haven't had a chance to get in there and test it out myself, but I'm going to spend some time this weekend, hopefully, getting in there and
let's see what we got with
like
that.
Everybody else.
Okay. How about all those... You know, I don't know where we are in the announcement process, but how about all those things like the control cost dummy, chainsaw?
The decorations. I think we have some art. I think Paul has art lined up for decorations.
Okay. Whoa. Look at that.
They should be going on sale sometime this week. We're still trying to get
decorations
the pack set up
for
we're gonna
sale.
Sell a gacha pack, in theory. But as soon as we get that pack all set up, which has been a little bit more complicated than it probably should have been, because...
they look cool, but
we're still trying to work through those processes with new staff and learn how to do it ourselves. Plus, it's on Galachain. It's the first time that the Townstar team, the Common Ground World team, has done.
They have any sort of utility.
Learn that process as well. So things are a little bit different. I think that's why some stuff has taken a little bit longer this time around than usual. Because now that we're on Galachain, some of the processes to get things set up are a little bit different. So thank you for bearing with us and being patient as we. Learn how to do things differently for the first time. Though it is awesome that we're on Galachain now. It's very, very exciting.
Yeah. Yeah, that was amazing to see come together.
That is actually a good thing. I do appreciate that very much.
Some questions about the cornfield. Do you want to clue in like Truk Tonka about some of that a little bit?
Yeah, cornfields. Also, would you get corn?
Okay. What was it like adding that? Was that a seamless, bug-free process, or maybe...
Oh, boy. Definitely, I find there's going to be ways to improve this, how we manage all our data and stuff. Because, you know, as a game designer, that's what I manage a lot. It's like a data wrangler. So, yeah, nice. It wasn't too bad. I got it all in.
Okay.
That's I feel good. Like that process was probably smoother than the process of us last week trying to make the starter town, which I think was like five or six iterations of trying to make sure it was a good starter town. That was that was a process. This week's starter town is also a different starter town.
Good, because that one was shit.
One to figure out.
Yeah.
It's too expensive.
I actually built a little tool so that we could build these towns faster. So that's why this one was a lot smoother than last week.
There you go.
That's great.
Yeah.
I was actually going to ask that because I haven't been part of that process, and maybe our players are wondering too. Like, when you're designing a starter town, what's that iteration like? Do you design it in the tool, in the grid, and then you play it? Do you typically how far do you go into it to see how it plays? Like, do you add stuff? Do you go to refineries or?
Yeah, not too far, just to make sure that the starter town gets you going. Because I think one of the issues that we thought about last week was like, oh, this could, if you played for, what was it, Michelle, like 20 or so minutes, you could be like,
you're gonna money. You run out of money.
Yeah, because the wages for the buildings wages were high, and it took a long time to make ceramic bowls and wax, so there's a chance you would like run out of money before you even made it to your first sale, which is why we adjusted the in-game cash up to 75 $1,000 last week to make sure that that didn't happen for players.
Oh, wow.
So just balancing that part out, I feel, is like the big part. Like if we make sure like there's enough time to get your town going, then it's all good.
Okay. That's a nice insight. Yeah, so you made, I guess for that one, you made the runway longer, but the speed the same. So you gave the 75K. If you extend the time that you go till you're out of money, but you're still going to go out of money just as fast, or did
exactly
you change, any of the wages?
Everything.
Change any of the wages.
Oh, okay.
They just give you more money.
Okay.
you about, still run out of money.
Talk about the trophies for the guilds. That seems like such an amazing thing.
I know everybody. I feel like everybody in the Discord has been, well, everybody that it was participated in that guild event that we did. I think it was in April. I'm not 100% sure. It was definitely a while ago, before May Mayhem. I think it was on Play Canvas still, back before we even launched the Godot game. But I think the original promise was leaderboard skins, but we found out that that wasn't really going to work out well in Godot, so we settled on some trophy decorations, which we have the art for. Hopefully that'll be up on the YouTube video soon.
Oh my god.
Paste one into the chat here.
Disaster.
So these are in-game trophies. This isn't just like an image we're putting, like, congratulations, right?
Yeah, they're actual NFTs. So there you'll own them. You can place them wherever you want in your town. They're going to be like a quarter of a tile, so they're going to be very small.
Okay. That's a good thing, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure, sure.
The way I've been playing lately, now that we've got the subgrid placement, people are getting more used to placing things kind of off grid versus how the game used to run. Sometimes you end up with a little bit of space or like a, you know, a tiny little corner of a tile, and you can put your trophy there now. Anybody
Why?
In those guilds?
Why?
There's Man, some of the fun. Concepts.
That's so cool. I'm trying to think of a game that's done that for the players before, like taken player content, guild names even, and put it in the game for people to see. That's really cool. Okay.
I do think it's super cool. Congratulations to those teams that did win. The winning team was a combination of Mafia and KAG. The second place team was NLO, and the third place team was Dub.
Super fun. Maybe there's hope for a Volcron statue in the future. Let's see. All right. Well, I'll talk a little bit about some of the upcoming features. We want you to be able to nuke your town from the main menu. That's important because sometimes, you know, your fast forward is going to take too long, or you want to start over. There's no point to load the game. So that's in progress. I know we mentioned it last week. We had a decent UI, but the more we kind of looked at it, it was like, it's not the best flow for players. So we do a UX pass on these things, and you know, we consider things like placement and color and how many clicks and all that. And it wasn't right where we wanted it to be. So that's still in progress. Functionally, it's done, but it just needs a better UI to it. Other upcoming features for the next week or so, we're going to be focused on guild features, designing those out, working with Wild Moopsie on any outstanding questions about that. His plans are really awesome. Should be super fun, collaborative, entertaining. I'm actually looking forward to it. And then, oh, this one I'm really excited about. I hope you guys don't mind me nerding out for a minute. So network traffic, let's see. Yeah, we're only 29 minutes in. Okay. I swear I'll keep it short. But, you know, a multiplayer game, this is technically a multiplayer game, even though it's just you and your town, right? There's thousands of other people playing at the same time.
Thousands?
In order to scale the game.
Funny.
You know, and we want to scale so that the servers are cheaper to run, so we can have more players for the same amount of money, spend more on advertising, rewards, whatever. We have to fix some of the networking in Godot. And I mentioned this last week, I think, maybe the week before. But one of our, we hired, I mentioned him before, as a actual Godot expert. Like, this guy makes YouTube videos and everything. He's working for us now, and he's been rewriting the underlying network stack. It's super exciting. We made a lot of progress this week. And it's really important, too, because sometimes if your network messages, if it gets clogged or lost or whatever, that can result in bugs that are super hard to reproduce. So overall, this is a big money and time saver. So that's coming up. And let's see. Let me just check Discord. You guys see any questions? I'm looking over our upcoming fixes.
I haven't seen any, no.
Okay. Any utility or just... Oh, that's one about the trophies, I think. Any utility or just decoration?
They're just decorations.
Okay.
They could add like a tiny little bit of something at least. Upcoming fixes, something.
Returning to the main menu.
I'm just like, anyway,
that's in progress. The Oopsie NFT buff was not working on the Common Drawn mode after a page refresh. Sometimes the inventory, when you open it, takes a really long time if you have lots and lots of NFTs. So we're buffering that out better. And when you're on the main menu and you're looking at competition, the icons, you know, obviously those are loaded off of nodes. Those are loaded over IPFS. We're going to cache those so that it doesn't try to load them every time. Nacho G, please fix the energy building bug. Okay.
Energy building bug?
And I will make sure that we are working on that.
Which one is that?
Yeah, I think QA was having some trouble consistently reproducing it so we could find the exact cause of the problem.
I don't really remember.
Let's see. All right, well, before we hop into any info about sales or things like that, let's give everybody in Discord a couple minutes here or seconds.
Yeah, does anybody have any questions? I didn't share the form in the announcements this week because I totally lost track of time. This week flew by. So sorry about that, but there was the only one question in the form, and that was about being stuck loading. So I just nuked their town, and that was that was the only question in the AMA form. So if anyone does have questions, let us know.
All right. Will we ever see feed go into the trough?
Yeah, I'm sure that art will be fixed.
It's just at some point.
Not a top priority.
Camera, I have an honest question. One sec. Okay. Well, is there anything we should say about upcoming sales while we're waiting?
The only sale, decorations. Again, they're just decorations. They're not, they don't have any utility or anything. They're all a quarter of a tile.
How much, though?
See, they'll be in a gacha style box. So there'll be like a random one that comes when you get it. I believe we set the sale price at $10.
Oh my god.
For some Halloween decorations.
$10?
Down in your town.
Mm.
Grab them when they come out.
$10, no utility, just decoration. Take space, can't do anything with them.
So.
I don't know, man.
Volcron, can we have fast forward fixed? He hates fast forward and finding out something being made like the oil. Well, Grundy, that's a few at once. Which fast forward follows the exact same logic that just playing does. So I'm not sure what you're referring to there. If your town is balanced and could operate unattended, like you walk out of your room for an hour, then you'll get the same thing if you close the browser, go away for an hour, come back.
Kind of, I think.
End of the game. That's all fast forward does. So. Camerar, when will we get the ability to share a code to see our towns so we can show off the trophies? I have a design for that, Camerar, and I don't know when we're going to put it in, but the vision is that this has to follow guilds because we're going to have, you know, user ID, copy paste, stuff like that. But the idea would be if somebody opens their town, you're like, hey, I'm going to let my friends see this, and then you share your town. A special ID with them, they'd be able to go in and just watch it run. They wouldn't be able to, you know, save anything, but they would be able to see your town and just look at it in spectator mode. Any changes coming? This is from Ive715. Any changes coming to Fast Forward to deal with an inaccurate leaderboard? Yeah, this comes up a lot. So, yes. In order
exactly.
to regularly update the leaderboard, what we have to do is run your fast forward for you, let's say every hour while you're offline. That's a work in progress. It depends a lot on DevOpsy stuff. So, yeah, I get it. That was over the whole life of this fast forward feature. That's been a question that came up a lot. When
see, LV Postman had like a follow up question to that. It says the data is somewhere. Why can't the leaderboard be accurate? That's the issue, is when your town is offline, the data is not anywhere because your town is offline. It does not show up until your town comes back online, which is when the leaderboard updates.
Yeah. Yeah, I think there's a perception some people have that when you log out, your town continues to run in real time or something. And that's just not the case. It goes into stasis mode, basically. It freezes. When EdiePlug says, when purchases CC purchases available again?
Yeah, I responded to that in chat. Should be mid to late November. The company is coming online, so...
Cool.
It's a work in progress.
When will we get the chance of different biomes? Maybe Moopsy could take that one. Have you seen the biomes in the long-term plans?
Oh, no, I haven't yet.
Okay.
We're going to be updating those. That's cool.
Well, there's the idea of when you're picking your town, depending on your consumables and other game design elements we haven't probably talked about yet, the option to re-roll a different biome.
I see.
Yeah. So it's a ways off, the captain.
Yeah, it's definitely pretty far off still.
Let's see, Grundy, back to fast forward. So it ran for 5 hours, had a 23-minute break, relog in. Oh, and the oil pumps had stopped working, so they just weren't pumping anything anymore. Okay, well, if you could DM me, Grundy, with some more info, I can help look into that with you on it. Let's see. NFT Madness, before we're going to move on to our next competition here in a sec, but NFT Madness, don't the calculations for Fast Forward take place on our PC? No, absolutely not. So you have to assume that anything running on somebody's personal computer is going to get tampered with. That was why we changed the whole design of the game to be server authoritative. The Fast Forward runs on the server. And when you see that little percent updating, that's just our server giving you a number like 3% updated, 12%, you know, and so on. So I hope that answers that question. LV Postman, last question. Can production monitor be made to keep running and accurate coming out of Fast Forward? Yeah, we talked about that as well. Already Fast Forward is pretty CPU heavy, and that wouldn't add too much, but it is a feature we'd like to have. It's in the backlog, as they say.
To be on the front log.
When will we get rewards for the last competition?
As I said earlier in the AMA, we're taking our time this week to look at a couple of things before we get them sent out. We're also still kind of onboarding new staff, so the process is going to take a little bit longer. Plus, things are on Galachain now, so it's just a little bit more complex than it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
So we're working through it. I would imagine early next week, probably. I don't think they'll be out today unless Wild Moopsy has any other information, but I think that we've still got some stuff to look at to make sure that the leaderboard is accurate and everything based on some of that new knowledge we got this week. So,
okay.
I hope they remove some people.
All right. Well, what should we say?
They got some cheaters? Oh my God. Back to cheating again, huh?
Information. I can post everybody the.
That's not good news.
Changes. Scroll through this. Here we go.
That's not really good news, is it?
Jack Lanterns are going to return back to normal. They'll be back at 721 stars. Wax is going back down to 2,000 in cash, back to its standard value. We're going to keep Cotton Yarn cash boosted at 6,500 for this next week. Chocolate bars are also going to be cash boosted, as is cornstarch. So chocolate bars will be 12,000, which is a lot for chocolate bars. And cornstarch will be 6,500 for in-game cash. And then the trick-or-treat bags themselves are going to be 100,000 stars, whereas their standard value would normally be 3,126 stars.
Nice.
So those are all your star values for this
we
week.
Could.
The biome has already been posted. The gas is, what is it? I think it's 20 seconds and 10 seconds this week. Yep. Right. Somebody with a regular trade depot would be 20 seconds. It'll be 10 seconds for those express depots and express piers.
I guess we'll work out on the layout soon. Maybe today.
Nice.
The rewards will continue to go to the treasure chest for the time being.
Okay.
It's been annoying, but anyway.
I feel like I saw another question. I see JJ asking for when fixed the 2 out of 1 energy bug, and I know for a fact that I saw engineers in QA talking about it internally.
Yeah, we had many of those.
Looking at it.
Yep,
yeah,
sure.
And it is not just energy. It's most passive things. It happens when you move your NFTs around when crafts have like already been accumulated, so.
Yep, that happens.
Value, question mark. Sugar pie.
For what? For trick-or-treat bags? It's not any different than its standard value for trick-or-treat bags. For a treat bag. And that is 126,820 each.
That's such a cool bot.
I know. I'm so happy that I got them all set up.
It seems like people enjoyed this meta. You know, we got Dubstep, Postman, Lonely Island, O-Town commenting. Please make meta no money every week.
We can't do that every week, but for sure we'll do it on occasion.
It's interesting. It just, and it keeps you more engaged with the game, even though. Even though that's not what happened with my case, and I just like let it run and lost some ranks, but it definitely adds up like some flavor and some interruptibility with the game. More dynamic. More dynamic into it, so you keep more engaged. There's more stuff to do, not just like build and sleep, you know.
So
that's definitely something to consider for sure.
Check in for Postman.
Don't mind that at all.
To be more social, Truck says.
No one's gonna be Jimmy.
Well, one day.
One day.
I'm sure that Jimmy will make an appearance back into the game. How, I don't know, but I'm almost 100% positive that there will be a Jimmy in the game at some point.
Wild Moopsie, did you ever see Jimmy? Any pictures of him, or are you aware of what he did?
It's Jimmy, okay. No.
Oh, okay. I joined right as we turned him off in the Play Canvas version of the game. Farmer Michelle, do you remember any of the problems with Jimmy?
Yes, I was still a community member and just playing Townstar for fun when Jimmy was in the game. I was also part of a guild, so we used Jimmy quite a lot. Really what would happen, how competitions used to run is it guilds and teams would kind of work together to try to build one craft. So instead of like each individual town making like blue steel, for example, you would all work together and like one person would set their town up and just make the cotton yarn and one person would set their town up and just make the wool yarn. And Jimmy would transfer the goods between one town to another. You could even have one town in the middle that was just making lumber or two or three towns just making lumber that would have Jimmy on all four sides sending lumber to all the other towns.
I see.
There was a lot of different strategies. You could have just one town that only made gasoline for all of the other towns and just sent gasoline in a big, you know, line through Jimmy's all the other towns. But it was getting exploited because you could, if you were multi-accounting, which is against the rules, you could set up a second town, put it next to your town, and then you would have two towns, which is unfair compared to other people who are only playing on one town.
Mm-hmm.
You could also just start up a town and send all 40 gasoline over and then delete that town and start another town again and never have to make gasoline.
Oof,
so there was a lot of issues that happened with Jimmy, which is why he was removed from the game in order to find a better solution to that, which is a very fun part of the game, being able to send goods to your friends so that you can work as a team.
Mm-hmm.
We've discussed this so many times.
He was just too OP.
Yeah.
Discussed this so many times. This would be so dynamic for guilds to play. Like, if we could avoid those issues of cheating, that it would be so cool if we could do this.
A little bird popped in my head and told me to say something. Was that, Paul, was that for Michelle or? Oh, okay. So
our
legendary.
12 minutes left until our crops get renewed.
That's right, good Paul was on. Yeah. You were on a Townstar team when I first started.
So we kind of stopped here for a bit.
You were on the Townstar team with us.
He was the one who actually pushed the button to turn off Jimmy. That's interesting. Since we got a couple minutes, Moopsy,
everybody can sleep now.
Like game design problems like that in the past, like multi-accounting and players finding cheats through cooperative action and things like that. Where does that fall in terms of how does, when you're designing a feature, what is the best way in your, or what is a good way to get the team to find those exploits and stuff? Do you think it's good to reach out to the community and have like the world's best cheaters join your team for an afternoon, or what kind of patterns have you succeeded with in the past on that kind of stuff? Just like a break it Friday or?
Yeah, definitely like doing research, right? Finding other examples out there. You know, there's millions and millions of games out there. And a lot of times, there are systems that those games use that is something that we could use too. So do some research, hopefully make a prototype and start playtesting internally, seeing if people internally can already exploit it.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you kind of get into a good spot, getting the community involved is always a great way. Because, they're the, end players, right? They're the ones who are going to really, find every single exploit possible. And then from there, you iterate and improve.
Okay. That sounds so scientific.
Yeah.
That's great. well, that is it for our agenda. What do y'all say? You want to hang out for a minute and answer questions, or you think we covered pretty much everything?
I think we pretty much went through everything.
I think after this, we'll just take a break.
Right. I see Gronk just asking about the event and stuff.
Try to look at it at the
game spending in the game, which is not in the game yet.
At the new layout and new products to see if it's already in game, so you can start maybe building something, or even like adapting a layout, or at least like starting a new town for cash, so we have enough money to build
probably a new token launch
test for the next competition. That's still
upgradable NFTs.
Still waiting. I mean, my town is at 88% still loading up. I forgot to turn it off, and it's,
I think,
fast forward, we're on since for last week.
Reward those node owners, so the ability to level up your nodes
I think we're gonna take a break here with
last I saw on the big roadmap there.
With Legacy,
there's been a drop off in player numbers in the past few.
It's the late minutes until this refreshes, so there's not much we can do.
Maybe we can
wonder if you could build another one.
DAU
restore stock. Yeah, I can't really build another one. You can restock.
You can definitely look at the leaderboards.
But yeah, it's nothing we can do here too. On a free to play basis, that's it. You just get stalled out.
That was
so unfortunately, can't do anything else.
Everybody has a good spooky last weekend before Halloween.
Well.
Thanks for joining
everybody
us.
Everybody be safe out there if you're going out.
That was it.
Yeah. And remember,
that was a AMA.
You are on all of our social media, make sure to like and subscribe. Get notifications. And if you see bugs, DM me or bring it up in the channel. So thanks so much for joining us on this AMA. Thanks for joining us, Wild Moopsy. Ninja Surprise, Farmer Michelle.
Yeah.
And there we go. That's it.
Thanks for hosting for
all
us.
Right. I'll catch up with you guys later.
Always a pleasure.
And, yep.
All right, guys.
I'll be back later with,
and
maybe.
Here we go. See you later.
With Downstar.
Bye.
Bye.
See ya. Bye-bye.